Hey everyone, welcome back and thanks for tuning in to episode 17 of LabPadre, SpaceX, and Starbase weekly updates. We got a short one for you this week, so let's dig in. The 24th started with testing preparations for B7.1 as crews took a look and worked inside the tank. Booster 7's methane tank valves were observed venting pressurized gas in a tank pressurization test on the orbital launch mount. Over at the build site, the Starship Squid was brought into the high bay and attached to the bridge crane. Vacuum Raptors were moved into the high bay as well the following day to be attached to Ship 24. On the 27th, Booster 7 began its first-scale cryo testing since the last visit to the launch mount. Cryogens flowed through the plumbing in the launch mount with no observable vehicle filling taking place. After spending several months on display alongside other starships, Booster 5 finally made its way to the build site, affording some interesting close-ups at the booster's engine plumbing. Meanwhile, at the launch site, Booster 7's tanks continued to undergo gas fill pressure testing with additional tank venting events observed. While Booster 7 was being tested, some venting was also seen from the plumbing near the orbital launch mount. Coordinating things at the production site can be tricky, and this is readily seen in the coordinated relocation of several cranes from SpaceX and their contractors. After being transported to the bays, crews removed one of the grid fins from Booster 5. Once the fin was removed, Booster 5 headed into the mega bay for disassembly and scrapping. As the 28th began, Ship 24 was placed on the high bay ship stand for installation of Raptor vacuum engines. Frost was later seen forming on the B7.1 tank as a can crusher was put to work, applying simulating loads to the test article. As SpaceX inches closer to the first orbital flight test, routine deliveries of methane keep a steady pace at the orbital fuel farm. The following day, crews got to work testing with Booster 7 and Stage 0, with venting coming from both the mount vehicle and the orbital launch platform. The following morning, the new Starlink V2 loader was seen making its way towards high bay. This hardware is used to load the Starlink satellites into Starship ahead of a launch. Booster 5 began its disassembly on Thursday as its methane tank was cut and removed. As June came to an end, a farewell was made to Booster 4 as it rolled its way down Highway 4 one last time. This important test article aided the further verification of SpaceX's ground systems and vehicle hardware. Just as the day before, testing of Booster 7 and Stage 0 continued, with venting seen coming from the orbital fuel farm as well as the booster quick disconnect. Later that day, SpaceX's robotic dog Zeus was once again seen making its way across the launch complex. That afternoon, the Starlink loader was seen being raised at high bay next to Ship 24 for a possible alignment test ahead of operational testing. And finally for this week, we got to bring you the launch of SES-22, a geosynchronous transfer orbit aboard Falcon 9 from the Space Launch Complex 40 in Cape Canaveral, Florida. And there you have it, another Starbase weekly update brought to you by LabPadre. Make sure you subscribe and hit the alert bell for video notifications. We'll see you next week, and thanks for watching. LabPadre out.